I'm Assistant Sheriff Brett Zimmerman, and I'm here to provide additional details as we know them today on the officer-involved shooting we investigated on June 9th, 2018. Comparing it from years past, OIS number 7 this year, non-fatal number 4 for 2018, and at the same time last year, we were at OIS number 8, and fatal was at number 5. Date, time, and type of call. The call originated on June 18th, 2018 at 10:48 a.m., and it was an investigative follow-up in manner of our detectives looking for a suspect. The location of our OIS was at 3790 Blue Diamond Road, located within the Enterprise Area Command. And you can see on the scene to the left of my map of the location, it occurred at a gas station on the corner there of Blue Diamond and Valley View. The time of the OIS was shots fired approximately on June 9, 2018 at 12:35 a.m. The involved officer was Sergeant Joseph Emery, that's E-M-E-R-Y. He's 53 years of age and has been with the LVMPD for 28 years. He's assigned to the Major Violators Narcotics Crimes Division. In this incident, Sergeant Emery was armed with a Glock 21 45 caliber handgun equipped with a tactical light. The investigation revealed Sergeant Emery fired 14 rounds during this incident. A taser was also deployed by a secondary witness officer at the scene. Our suspect is it's pronounced Shan, but it's S-H-A-N, Kittredge. His picture's up there. He's 38 years old, white male adult, 5 feet 7, 190 pounds. And again, he's pictured to my left. Kittredge has a very long, extensive criminal history, and I'll start with the most recent. He had a battery in 2017. These are all LVMPD jurisdiction crimes, unless I say differently. He has possession of a credit card without owner's consent in 2017, possession of a controlled substance in 2017, possession of a dangerous weapon in 2017, battery DV 3 times in 2017, possession of a controlled substance in 2016, possession of a credit card without owner's consent on 4 occasions in 2016, a prior for trafficking controlled substance in 2016, trafficking a controlled substance in 2014. In 2004, he was a fugitive for armed robbery. He had a probation violation, Department of Public Safety in 2004 in New Mexico. Convicted person, possession of a firearm in LVMPD's jurisdiction in 2004. Another possession of a controlled substance in 2004. Possession of stolen vehicle in 2004. And obstructing a police officer in 2003. And again, all those were in LVMPD's jurisdiction. His charges, he had a active robbery warrant at the time of the officer-involved shooting. He had a battery warrant, and there were also additional charges pending related to the robbery series, as well as the OIS. And we had learned in our briefing prior that he was due in court this morning for some of these previous charges, that he was going to be sentenced, which he was released earlier in the year and was appearing for sentencing. His weapon is shown on the screen. It's a Taurus 9mm semi-automatic, model PT-111. And the magazine capacity is 12 rounds. It was recovered with 8 rounds in the magazine and 1 round jammed in the chamber. The details of the OIS are as follows. On Friday, June 8th at approximately 10:48 a.m. in the 200 block of Tropicana, LVMPD Major Violator Detectives established surveillance on a prolific armed robbery suspect that was involved in an ongoing robbery series. This suspect had committed 8 armed robberies in a 2-week period, and he was becoming progressively more violent. At approximately 12:30 a.m., later that day into the early morning on June 9th, the suspect was followed to a convenience store located at 3790 Blue Diamond Road, where he exited his vehicle to pump gas. The suspect then entered the store, and when he exited, our detectives saw this as an opportunity to take him into custody. Detectives positioned their vehicles in front and rear of the suspect's vehicle to block him in and prevent his escape. Detectives gave commands to the suspect, instructing him to get on the ground. The suspect initially complied and laid on the ground. However, he got back up and entered his vehicle. Once inside the vehicle, he put it in reverse gear, attempting to drive away, almost striking a canine officer and did strike a Metro vehicle. Sergeant Emery saw the suspect, after getting back into his vehicle, raise a firearm and aim it directly at him and another detective. When the suspect was backing up, Sergeant Emery knew the canine officer was to the rear of the vehicle and he was concerned for that officer's safety. Sergeant Emery fired a second time due to the suspect raising the firearm and aiming towards another Metro vehicle. Sergeant Emery believed another detective was standing in that direction. Inside of the suspect vehicle, a Taurus 9mm semi-automatic handgun was recovered on the driver's side floorboard. Medical attention was immediately summoned for the suspect. Arriving medical personnel transported Kittredge to UMC, where he was listed as being in stable condition. I will now show you video obtained from one of the canine officer's body-worn camera, as well as video from our air unit.
I'm sorry, is that for Delta 1450, sir?
Delta 1450, runway 268, taxi via Charlie.
268 via Charlie, Delta 1450.
1450, your departure frequency will be 125.9er.
25.9 for departure, Delta 1450.
Pleasure, here's Delta.
Oh, I'm good.
He's back in the car, back in the car. Okay. Both shots fired.
Air 5, shots fired. We're going to be Valley View and Blue Diamond. Start units this way.
Get medical, please, Bowser.
I'm on the same car. See Charlie.
Air 5, read.
They're still shooting. Get medical.
See Charlie.
Air 5, shots fired with the rope units out here. Roll medical and have them stage. Start units this way.
Get on the ground! Yeah. Pinch him! Pinch him! He slumped over!